Hello friends, welcome to my channel Data Making. In this video, I am going to discuss about the next interesting transformation called coalesce. Okay, so what coalesce transformation does is, basically it is reduces the number of transformation in the RDD. Okay, you can pass the integer number, okay, to which the number of transformation has to be reduced. Okay, say example, you have a RDD which consists of 4 partition. Okay, so if you want to minimize to 2 partition, okay, what it's going to do is, it is going to, from the original RDD, say example, it is going to have the 4 partition, right? It will keep the 2 partition, okay, it will retain the 2 partition, okay, it takes the data from other 2 partition, it appends to the existing 2 partition, first 2 partition. That's how the coalesce is going to work. It is not going to do any random shuffle on your data. So instead, it is going to retain the old partition, okay, and get the other data from the remaining partition, and it gets appended. That's how it works. Let's see with the example so that it will be very clear. I am going to log in my video. Okay, before that, let me minimize my recording window. Okay, sorry for the background noise. Okay, so I have logged into my VM. So almost last 2 videos I started using a Jupyter notebook for running our PySpark code. If you don't know how to configure it, I have done a separate video for that, configuring or setting up the Python Jupyter for your PySpark. Please follow the video, and if you have any clarification, put the your queries or question on the comment section of the video. I'll help you out. Okay, so example, we are going to see the how to use the coalesce RDD transformation. So what does coalesce does is decrease the number of partition in the RDD to num partition, whatever the partition number you pass, useful for running operation more efficiently after filtering down the large data set. Okay, that's how the coalesce does. So what I am going to do is, I took the simple example, right? So in this example, so I just created the set of names, okay, for simplicity sake or for better understanding. I just given abcd-1, abcdef-1, ghi-1. I just repeated the same number with the -2, 3, and 4. Okay, basically we have a 12 elements. Okay, 12 names in my names list, in the Python list. If you want to convert the Python list to RDD, so you have to use the parallelize function in the Spark context and pass the Python object, and also provide the number of partition you want to create on this RDD using this Python object. So if you pass 4, there will be a RDD with the 4 partition. Each partition will have different elements based on the number of elements in the Python object. So you can just check the verify the number of partition in the RDD by using the function called getNumPartitions. So there is another function called gloam. Okay, so this function, okay, basically what it does is, it is going to give you the each element, number of elements, or I would say each element in the all the elements in the each partition. Okay, say example, we actually converted this entire Python list into RDD of 4 partition, right? So you can actually see this. This is a function actually act as a transformation, which is going to return the partition wise elements. Okay, after that you can, it will give you the RDD. So after that you can do the collect action, RDD action, to see the values. Okay, so what it does is, it takes the RDD. Okay, so in the first, if you see this list is going to give you as a list. So in the first partition you have 3 elements, abcd-1 def-1 ghi-1, and the second partition you have 3 elements, it's ending with 2 2 2. Third partition you have 3 element ending with 3 3 3. Fourth partition you have 3 element ending with 4 4. So this gloam function is very helpful to visually see the elements in your each partition. Okay, now let us come to the coalesce transformation. What is coalesce transformation? I'm going to use the Coriolis transformation is we have already a four partition. I'm going to minimize, reduce the two into two partition. Okay, when I do this, okay, so what is happening is it is going to retain the first two partition. Okay, so first two partition is ABC-1, DEF-1, DHI, and similarly ABC-2, DEF-2, and GHI-2, and it is going to append the other elements from the partition, different partition. So it retained the 1 and 3. So from two, from the elements from the second partition is appended in the first partition. Elements from the fourth partition appended in the third partition. If you see this after Coriolis, okay. If you apply the GLOM function on the Coriolis RDD, which is converted as a two partition, you see these elements in the first partition and second partition, how it looks. So if I want to increase the number of partition, I cannot use the Coriolis. Even if I use, I will not get, actually it will not work. Basically it will just give the number of partition in the existing RDD. So I just tried to do this partition names underscore RDD as four partition, right? I try to increase the into six, but it is not working. Basically it's not throwing any error, but just gives the four partition with the RDD. Okay, RDD elements. Let me try the get num partition. Num partitions. So it just give the four. So Coriolis function or the RDD transformation cannot increase the number of partition. Okay, basically it does. It can reduce the number of partition. Okay, so it is not going to do any shuffling. Okay, this is how the Coriolis work. It will be very useful when you want to reduce the number of partition without shuffling your data. Okay, I hope this video is helpful to you all. Please subscribe to my channel to get more technology videos, and also please go through my other playlist. I have a playlist for Apache Spark for beginners, Apache Spark for beginners with Python as well as Scala, and also I have two projects in implemented using Spark, and I have a machine learning tutorial as well. As please watch these videos and provide your feedback. I am welcome to I'm happy to help you all. Thank you so much, friends. See you in the next video.